you tear your own civilization down from the inside, if you tear yourselves apart, eventually a challenger will come along.
It's often occurred to me that you don't necessarily perceive threats while they're going on, because, you know, you get up, you have your, you make your egg, you have your cup of coffee, you say hello to your friends. Everything seems to be going along as it always has done, except at a certain point it all falls apart.
The West is absolutely under threat. It is under threat from ideas and from other nations, and that those other nations are operating under the effect of bad ideas. So it is a war of ideas, and if we don't sort out our war of ideas, we're going to have a lot more actual wars.
The West is under attack. We live in the freest, healthiest, and wealthiest societies in human history. Yet as authoritarian and oppressive regimes threaten us from without, a new movement within tells us to feel nothing but shame for who we are.
What is at stake if the West really fully disassociates from its own core and fails to remember and understand itself and to treasure those precious things that we've inherited? I think a light will go out in the world, a light will go out in human history, and there's no guarantee that light, once extinguished, will ever be relit.
If we don't acknowledge our existence as a tradition, we're in no position either to continue it, to defend it when it needs defending, or to reform it in a proper way when reform is truly indicated. Unless we come to understand who we are and where we've come from, we can't go forward in an intelligent way.
But as long as we have a sense of self-confidence, the willingness to stand up for our values, the willingness to fight for what we believe in, we can prevail. But weakness, self-loathing, hatred for the past, and any sign of giving in to the enemies of freedom will result in victory for our enemies. So we must never allow that to happen. We have to prevail. We have to win.
Welcome to the West. This is my take on the great and still unfolding adventure of who we are and why it matters. This is a history of how our extraordinary, unconventional civilization came to be and why it must be defended. It's a fascinating and often unexpected journey, stretching back 15 centuries to the fall of Rome.
And one of the difficulties about Western civilization is because, just as I've said, it's so complex. It's an ecosystem, and there's not just one word which defines it, like communism or fascism. It is really complex, and so there's not one word. I mean, the best, I suppose, is the open society, or maybe the free society, but it hasn't got a proper ideology. It's emerged, and it's incredibly valuable.
The first Westerners were primitive barbarian tribes. In time, Christianity and the power of law produced an open and innovative culture like nowhere else.